decision for certain for decision for rest. It is my honor to introduce to you Professor Wahid Yusri. Professor Wahid Yusri is a professor of surgical oncology who was the head of the Department of Surgical Oncology in the NCI for 3 years, and during this time he introduced many techniques in the NCI, including the robot for surgery in the GIT, urinary and gynecological tumors. He introduced radio frequency for liver tumors and other tumors, and he introduced the hyper in the NCI, and he was a member of the Egyptian Cancer Society and the head of the Egyptian Society of Surgical Oncology, and a member of the European Society of Surgical Oncology and the Society of Surgical Oncology in the United States. He is also now the head of the peritoneal surface malignancy, and he has good efforts and has shared in a lot of conferences, international and national.
Thank you, Professor Gamal. My talk today will be about two topics mainly. Managing the high-risk breast cancer patients, because in Egypt until now we don't have any plan to manage this category of breast cancer patients, including breast cancer patients themselves or patients at high risk for developing breast cancer. So my talk today will be a review about the recent consensus about management of this type of patients. This is the risk of breast cancer. As you can see, if you have a positive family history of breast cancer, which represents 10% of cases, the percent of all breast cancer cases will be from 15 to 20, and the average risk of breast cancer until the age of 70 will be 10 to 15%. If you have a positive BRCA or one or two mutations, which represent less than 1% of the breast cancer cases, the percent of all breast cancer cases will be from 5 to 6, and 50 to 85% at the age of 70. The general population without positive risk of or family history of breast cancer is about 7%. So this is a general risk. If we have the lifetime probability for developing breast cancer according to all sites, including the breast, it is 1 in 7 regarding the breast cancer as regards the international figures. Compared to other types of cancer, the highest is the, as you can see, is the all sites, 1 in 3, and in colon and rectum, 1 in 18. But the breast is 1 in 7, so one of the highest rates internationally. And hereditary breast cancer, whether familial or hereditary, it represents 10 to 15% or 5 to 10% as a hereditary cancer, compared to about 80% of the sporadic cancer cases. So women with BRCA1 or BRCA2 mutations, when we might consider prophylactic mastectomy in these cases? So we must have a genetic testing first to be sure that the case is a carrier of BRCA1 or BRCA2 gene. And as you can see, BRCA mutations increase the risk of breast cancer according to NCI in 2003. Breast cancer by the age of 50, 33 and up to 50%. And by the age of 70, it can reach up to more than 87%. Compared to ovarian cancer, which can go up to 27 to 44%. So BRCA mutations, surgical intervention can offer a risk reduction. If we have a bilateral prophylactic mastectomy, 90% risk reduction, not 100%, because we have some residual disease, of the, some residual tissue of the breast. So if we compare the different types of breast regarding subcutaneous mastectomy or skin sparing with or without nipple preservation, which of course will have a better cosmesis and immediate reconstruction, bilateral salpingo-oophorectomy on the other side reduce the risk by 77% in all cases regarding the all causes of breast cancer mortality up to age of 70. So genetic mutations other than BRCA1 or BRCA2 gene, we have the Cowden syndrome and the Romini syndrome also, with increased risk up to 50% and 60% in the second genetic mutation. So who should consider genetic testing for BRCA1 or 2? We must have a high risk group because the test is very expensive and still in the very early stage in Egypt. And we start to recommend this type of testing to a certain group of patients. Breast cancer diagnosed before the age of 50, bilateral breast cancer and ovarian cancer in the same woman or in the same family, multiple breast cancer in the same family, two or more primary types of BRCA1 or BRCA2 related cancers in single family member, cases of male breast cancer, Ashkenazi Jewish ethnicity, also considered as a high risk for BRCA mutation. Prophylactic bilateral mastectomy, in which we remove the breast, which is normal at that time, but it is at a high risk for developing breast cancer. So breasts can be removed or remove a contralateral breast in patients with a breast cancer, what we call prophylactic contralateral mastectomy. When we are going to have prophylactic or advise having prophylactic contralateral mastectomy away from genetic mutation. So prophylactic mastectomy or bilateral prophylactic mastectomy is a lifetime risk of developing breast cancer for the average American woman is about 12% on the maximum. Prophylactic mastectomy has been performed for decades without many reports. Bloodgood was the first to report prophylactic mastectomy in the year 1921. Bilateral prophylactic mastectomy began to be commonly performed in late 60s and 70s, early 70s. In 1980, Pensini and Caguzzi published data on 1,500 patients undergoing subcutaneous mastectomy with a family history of breast cancer, and was reported in 41 of cases in this series before genetic testing. In 1997, the Cancer Genetic Study Consortium published a consensus statement on the optimal care of individuals carrying BRCA1 or BRCA2 genes. There is insufficient evidence to recommend for or against prophylactic mastectomy. It will be an individual decision. In the year 1989, the procedure started to increase worldwide. The most common cause is contralateral breast cancer in high-risk patients, and very rarely performed in Egypt until now. Other factors for very high risk of breast cancer: strong family history of breast cancer before the age of 50. As we mentioned before, multiple members in the same family, lobular carcinoma and cytoplasmic family history of breast cancer. Many surgeons consider prophylactic mastectomy as an aggressive approach for women with lobular carcinoma in situ, even in absence of a family history of other risk factors. Chest irradiation before the age of 30, dense breasts or breasts with diffuse microcalcification as the screening for the breast cancer is more difficult. So SSO position statement on prophylactic mastectomy in year 1993 and revised in year 2001-2007, potential indications for bilateral prophylactic mastectomy or contralateral mastectomy, BRCA or other genetic mutations, strong family history with no demonstrable mutations, histologic risk factors, or other high risk factors. Regarding contralateral prophylactic mastectomy, we will have risk reduction, of course, in cases with difficult surveillance, and reconstructive issues must be discussed regarding the experience and facility and the balance also with the patients. So contralateral prophylactic mastectomy to remove contralateral breast during breast cancer surgery. Contralateral mastectomy reduces the risk of breast cancer in that breast, but it is not yet known whether this risk reduction translates into longer survival or not. So usually who asks for contralateral prophylactic mastectomy? Young patients with higher education, family history of breast cancer, and tumor factors that can be discussed with a treating physician. So tumor factors to be discussed for possible contralateral prophylactic mastectomy when we have an invasive glomerular carcinoma, multicentric tumors, or tumor size. As we can see, for invasive ductal carcinoma, the patient study, the risk at 55 months is 4.2. For invasive glomerular carcinoma, it is slightly higher, 4.5%. And we can see contralateral breast mastectomy rate. It is usually increasing over time for glomerular carcinoma in situ. So treatment factors also must be considered. BRCA testing, preoperative use of MRI, because now with regular use of MRI in young patients with dense breast, we can have better diagnosis than the routine mammography. Of course, the facility also must be included in the treatment factors, including the surgeon's experience and the facility experience and the available cost for that procedure regarding insurance or private patients also must be discussed. Of course, after Angelina Jolie, the rate of discussing and proposing prophylactic mastectomy has increased worldwide. Why the rates are increased worldwide? It is unclear until now, maybe because of awareness about genetic testing and the pathological factors and the higher risk factors, including the early detection programs. Better reconstructive issues are very important over the last 20 years. Increased BRCA and other gene testing, overestimation of breast cancer risk also have been considered as a factor among the normal population. So, overestimation of breast cancer risk to be discussed. Patients with early breast cancer overestimate risk of recurrence, fear of recurrence, and the peace of mind. Some patients ask that I will take the breast out because I don't like to have a contralateral breast cancer and they are afraid of recurrence. In a study of Han et al., year 2010, of 350 mastectomy patients, the most common reason for contralateral mastectomy was worry about contralateral breast cancer in 81% of cases. And also, Abbott found that breast cancer patients overestimated the risk of contralateral breast cancer to be 31 at 10 years, which is away from the regular facts that already studied before. So the actual risk of developing contralateral breast cancer for ER-positive patients treated with tamoxifen is 0.4% per year, 4 to 5% at 10 years. For ER-negative patients, slightly higher, and all subtypes, 0.75% per year. In the ATTACK trial, the incidence of contralateral breast in women after aromatase inhibitors was 3.3%, decreasing the rate. And the risk of prophylactic mastectomy also must be discussed with the patient. It's not a very simple operation to be carried in a patient with a normal breast. So we have an early and late complications. Quality of life, which includes satisfaction with the patient, must also be calculated and discussed, and of course, the cost of the procedure. So anesthesia complications, bleeding, infection, pain, disfigurement, anxiety, and disappointment, complications arising from breast reconstruction, and the need for multiple operations must be discussed. Regarding the quality of life and complications, the quality of life may be improved, freedom of worry, freedom from imaging and biopsy, and symmetry of the breast can be achieved by reconstructive surgery. Late complications, including sexual function, loss of sensation in the breast, or decreased sensation in the breast, 23% of cases, body image in 61% of cases, chronic pain after surgery have been reported also. So satisfaction was 90% and 86% in two different studies. As you can see, satisfaction ranges between 75% and 95% according to the procedure, whether subcutaneous or simple reconstruction, or simple with reconstruction, simple with no reconstruction. Still, we have some patients up to 13% not satisfied after the procedure. So the cost also must be discussed. Mean cost of treatment for women age 45 are comparable. Contralateral breast mastectomy is not cost effective for women after the age of 70. The MD Anderson had a study and looked for the cost of contralateral breast mastectomy. The group had significantly increased in the mean total cost compared to non-contralateral breast mastectomy. This is a study of MD Anderson. And the surgical complications also have been studied, including flap necrosis, infection, loss of implants. The Canadian group discovered that contralateral breast mastectomy associated with increased wound complications and overall postoperative complications. The NSQIB data of more than 20,000 patients who underwent unilateral or bilateral immediate reconstruction were examined by Silva et al. Bilateral mastectomy was associated with longer hospital stay, higher transfusion rate than unilateral mastectomy. Bilateral mastectomy with autologous reconstruction was associated with a higher wound failure, as reported in this series. Regarding the disease-free survival, no effect for contralateral or mastectomy on the disease-free survival by most of the studied series. Contralateral breast mastectomy and overall survival, the disease-free survival, overall survival is not affected by this type of procedure according to Harrington et al. Decision-making process for prophylactic mastectomy. Number one, fear of recurrence. 2/3 of women stated that the choice of contralateral breast mastectomy was self-driven. In contrast, women who said that decision was made by the doctor had low rates, 6%. Surgeon play a crucial role in patient decision making. Other options to reduce the risk of future breast cancer in high risk patients: intensified screening program, hormonal treatment reduce the breast cancer risk by 50% in estrogen receptor positive patients, including different drugs, tamoxifen, Evista, aromazine, and aromidex. Prophylactic salvage-oophorectomy in premenopausal women reduce the risk by 50% as compared to 90% in prophylactic mastectomy. Healthy lifestyle may also reduce the risk. So prophylactic oophorectomy also reduce the risk of cancer ovary and cancer tube, reduce the risk of breast cancer by 42%, from 42 to 21% by removing the source of estrogen, and having hormone replacement therapy after salvage-oophorectomy for ovarian cancer, I think, must be discussed. Benefit extended to those benefit extent for those even diagnosed with breast cancer. The role of primary cancer peritoneum is uncertain and also must be discussed. In summary, prophylactic mastectomy in BRCA patients and high-risk patients reduce the risk of breast cancer by 90%. Rates of contralateral breast cancer have increased in high-risk patients. Prophylactic mastectomy with autologous reconstruction is associated with higher wound failure and higher transfusion rate. Cumulative risk for developing of contralateral breast cancer in normal risk patients is low. Potential complications of contralateral prophylactic mastectomy must be considered when advised. Help our patients to understand the risk of systemic metastasis and recurrence. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Professor Wahid, for this nice illustrative talk about prophylactic mastectomy and about hereditary familial breast disease. Any questions?